Hi, my name is Amber with Whole Self Emergence Release and Restore Yoga, and today I'm going to offer just a short 10-minute practice to release tension and stiffness in the lower back. Lower back pain, stiffness, tension is something that we all experience from time to time for various reasons. It's one of the number one visits to the doctors in the US. So this is just going to be a quick short practice to offer my favorite poses for releasing that tension. So for this practice, we're going to be on our back the whole time, and you can either use a bolster or a folded blanket for the practice. So either one would work great. If you have either of those available, we'll get started. We're just gonna start by coming down onto our back. Take it nice and slow. And just fully release for the moment. Let everything get heavy. Let your back body just really start to settle, release. We want to access that parasympathetic state, nervous state before beginning, so that our body allows us to release. If we're in a stressed state, then our muscles will stay contracted and we won't be able to release tension from those deeper tissues in our body. So really taking that time to settle is important. Take a few deep breaths on those exhales. Just feel yourself letting go a little more and a little more. Bring the soles of the feet to the ground, knees are bent, ankles under your knees. And taking your folded blanket or your bolster, I think I'm actually going to use my folded blanket for this. The nice thing about this is that you can alter the height for your preference and what works for you. So we're gonna press into the soles of our feet, lifting our hips off the ground, just enough to bring our folded blanket right underneath our sacrum, right underneath our hips. And then once you're there, just really allow everything to settle, to get heavy again. And from here, you can explore, maybe walking your feet out a little further, see how that feels. You can come all the way onto your heels. If this is too intense, just bring your soles of the feet right back to the ground. You really want to be able to relax into the pose. If you overwork the pose, if you take this too far, then again, your muscles will contract, trying to protect you, and you won't get that release. So really just coming to that first edge, listening to your body, and then really releasing, feeling your hips and your sacrum being held here. We'll stay here for a couple minutes and just really allow some time for everything to release. A little deeper. With each exhale, feel yourself getting just a little heavier. Letting go just a little more, surrendering into the pose. Imagine on those exhales, releasing anything we don't need, any denseness. Creating space in our lower back for fresh energy, for lubrication, nutrients. Take your left knee in towards your abdomen, and we're going to extend our right leg out, coming onto the heel. And once you're here, just relax and release. Let your elbow or shoulders get heavy. Your arms are heavy. Your hands can either be clasped around your shin or the back of your thigh. And really release here. This is like a low lunge. Just doing it on our back, a little support to the lower back. A really good one for anything sciatic, really nice for the hips. can really feel it in my sacrum as well. Each exhale, just letting go a little more. Feel your legs softening, your thighs. The space opens. Continue to let go, scanning your whole body for tension and where you might be gripping and holding on. And then just focus on relaxing that area. We'll lower that left foot down. Bring your right knee in towards your abdomen, bringing your hands to wrap around either your shin or the back of your thigh. Extend the left leg out, coming onto your heel, and then again release, let go. Really relax the arms and the shoulders. Back of the head is heavy, the upper back, your hips, your sacrum resting on your support. And then really focus on relaxing and releasing through the hips, through the legs, the thighs. Lower that right foot back down. Bring the left foot next to the right foot. Press into the soles of your feet, lifting your hips just enough to slide your support out from underneath you. Slowly lower back down onto your sacrum, onto your back. Really slowly lower. Continue to let it release and relax onto the floor. Stay here for just a moment and let everything restabilize. Connecting to your breath. Bring the soles of the feet together. Walk them out a little far away from you. Don't want them real close to your groin. Bring your knees out to the sides. Just be here for a moment, releasing that lower back. Let everything go here. If this is really intense for you, you can also place a couple blocks underneath your thighs or folded blankets or cushions. We won't be here long. Bring your hands to your thighs, bring your legs back together. Slowly scooch your hips very slightly to the right, and we'll bring our knees down to the left, coming into a twist. And then if you have a lot of sensitivity in your lower back, I really recommend maybe placing your folded blanket or your bolster underneath your knees. Just a little extra support there. If you feel okay with them hovering or if they make it all the way down, that's completely fine to you, as long as you're able to relax without pain. And then once you're here, you can extend your arms out or cactus them. Maybe turn your head slightly to the right. And then really let go into the twist. Again, really focus on releasing from the torso all the way down through the hips, through the thighs. Stay right there with the sensation and with that sense of releasing. And slowly bring your chin back to center. Bring the rest of your body back to center. Bring your hips back to the ground. Feels really nice to have them nice and solid, touching your support, your ground right now, feeling held. Slightly scooch them to the left this time, and we'll bring our knees down to the right. And again, checking to see if you'd like some support underneath them. Once you're there, doing what you'd like with your arms, you can turn your head slightly to the left. Just whatever you need to. As you go, you really want to be able to relax. So it always, it's never a waste to take time setting up the pose to work for yourself. There's no rush. Slowly bring your chin back to center. Scooch the rest of your body back to center. Allow everything to settle for a moment. And we'll stretch our legs out. Maybe it'd feel good to bring your blanket underneath your knees for this part. Or your bolster. Just give a little space here. Let everything go. We'll just take a moment. Give our body a moment to reset and process from our really short little practice. And like you can see, I'm not doing this on a mat. You could do this on the carpet while watching TV at the end of the day, before you start your day. Just to let some of that tension go, to create space for something new in the body. New patterns, new ways of being, new inspiration. Go here. Maybe wiggle your fingers and your toes. You can reach your arms up overhead, bend the knees, take your knees side to side, giving yourself a nice stretch. And roll over onto your side. Slowly make your way up. Thanks so much for joining me. I hope your back feels just a little lighter, a little looser, and a little more relaxed.